here in game five. They know it. They just got to elevate their play even a little bit more here. And it might start with a power play goal if they can get it. They don't have many of them. Only three in the series. Shots are now 14-6 in the second period in favor of the Canucks.
$178 in our power play jackpot. Cam Eady of Port Coquitlam is playing for that money with the purchase of a big extra. $178 up for grabs as the Canucks try to break out of this what is now 1-for-17 drought, 3-for-32 in the series. Third attempt of the game. Here's Nazem at the left point. Rink wide, Sallow right point. Back into the middle. Jovanovski tips the puck to himself on the far board. Skates onto it. Now skates in deep, passes behind the net, out of the reach of Morrison. Jackman gets the puck, clears it off Naslin, ahead to Rachinski, who sends it all the way down the ice. Blues change, one forward and one defenseman as the Canucks move up ice. Bertuzzi missed the pass, then was checked to the ice by Jackman. Fans wanted a cross-check call, now Bertuzzi holds the puck in. Naslin turning on the right wing boards. Skates down, cuts in front, shoots, and it went off something and up high. Puck goes out of play in the corner to the right of Oscar. As Bertuzzi appears to be favoring his left wrist, which has been bothering a bit the last couple of games. He took that hit from Jackman just inside the St. Louis line. And Pronger's getting a penalty here. That's why his wrist is hurting, I guess. Chris Pronger must have given him a whack. It's a two-man advantage for Vancouver.
We're a minute and 18 seconds. Listen to this place. The fans can smell it. They can taste it. It's time to put the Blues away here in Game 5. For slashing.
Bertuzzi's going to stay out. He'd love to add insult to injury and get the power play goal here with a two-man advantage. Linden wins the draw, but Doug Waite gets to the puck and he's able to chip it out to center. Linden up front with Naz and Bertuzzi. Sopel and Jovanovski are the point men. Here's Linden carrying in. Passes to the right wing. Bertuzzi takes the puck, leaves it there for Naslin. Minute to go on the two-man advantage. Naslin back to Sopel, right point. Over to Jovanovski. Winds up, shoots, stopped by Osgood. Rebound, Linden passes back to Jovanovski. Looks to Linden, now feeds Sopel at the right point. Side of the net, Naslin looking in front, scores! Oh, captain, my captain, he baked it in off Osgood, and the Canucks lead 3-1. 4-1. I'm getting caught up.
The big boys are doing it tonight. Bertuzzi, Morrison, Naslin. Don't pay the ransom. They have escaped. They're back. Listen to the crowd. They know it's only one at a time now. But Vancouver, by far, their best offensive show of the series. And it comes when they need it the most, with their backs right up against the wall.
Second of the playoffs, scored on the power play by number 19, Marcus Naslund. The assist to number 3, Brent Sopel. And to number 55, Ed Jovanovski.
18:28, the time of the goal, and the Canucks are still on the power play. Henrik Sedin at the right point. Skates down the boards, feeds into the corner for Daniel. Up the boards for Henrik. Minute to go on the power play. Here's Olin to the line, but he can't hold the puck in. The Canucks have to regroup at center. Congratulations, Cam Eady. You won $178 on our McDonald's power play contest for that goal by Marcus Naslin. Now here's a chance for Bertuzzi in front. Stopped by Osgood with the left pad as Bertuzzi was in all alone trying to win $98 for Tom Rogers of Courtney. Man, the Canucks are pouring it on here in the second.
Well, everybody was concentrating, the Blues checkers, on the Sedins. They were right over the blue line, right down below us, and nobody picked up Bertuzzi.
Now Naslin moves in, shoots up high. Morrison gets the puck behind the net to Bertuzzi. He overskated it. Naslin intercepts on the far side. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Into the corner for Todd Bertuzzi. Bertuzzi tried to feed Naslin. That's picked off by LaFlamme, who now sends the puck ahead. Nash missed it. Here's Sopel at the line. And as he tried to make a move, he brought the puck out back in. Now we have some pushing on the whistle. Jovanovski and Podin. As there's just 12 seconds to go now in the
corner
minor.
Penalties here. I think Bertuzzi for sure. Elbowing. Elbowing is the call on Bertuzzi, and that's going to be the only penalty. So So Bertuzzi, who's made a habit of taking the Canucks off the power play with penalties in this series, does it again. So officially, Vancouver is 1-for-4, but it's a big one. Naslin's second of the series from Sopel and Jovanovski has given the Canucks a 3-goal cushion. So with 14 seconds remaining in the second period, Vancouver up by 3. They look to be in pretty good shape now.
14 seconds to go in the period, so they'll finish it 4-on-4, at least most of it. Blues will have the power play for 1 second, and then they'll begin the third period with the man advantage. It is 4-1. Don't pay any heed to what I had to say a moment ago. The Canucks exploding with 3 straight goals here in the second period as now the horn sounds, and Vancouver skates off with a 4-1 lead after 40 minutes of game 5.
Well, there's hope in Canucksville after all, and these fans showed their wonderful support when the team skated out onto the ice for the opening faceoff. It was a tremendous ovation, and the team has responded like they hadn't responded yet in this series.
Being tied up by Tkachuk, but fights off the check, and he's able to slide the puck all the way down the ice from his knees. Minute 25 to go on the power play as Ruutu comes out with Cook up front, Salo and Barron on defense. Tkachuk moves in on the right wing. Cuts in front with a wrist shot. And that went off the outside of the skate of Dan Klucha. Now here's Dimitri on the right wing board. Side of that to Tkachuk. Back to Dimitri. Dimitri right wing hash marks. Moves into the faceoff circle with a shot. Klucha stopped it with the right pad. Ruutu gets to the puck and lifts it out to center. Cook after it there. Trying to get around Dimitri. It does. Cook cutting it on goal. Shorthanded. And he put it off the crossbar. The puck hit the bar and went out of play as Matt Cook almost made it 5-1 Vancouver.
Boy, is that great hustle. The cookie monster. Everybody loves the cooker. Listen to it. Those are the kind of efforts that win hockey games. And you have to have those kind when you're in the playoffs, baby. Dimitri, who's under the weather with flu, only played about 3 minutes in the second period. Just didn't have the speed to cope with Cook there. And that was great hustle by Matt Cook. And he gets a scoring chance. Puts it off the goaltender's best friend, the post.
Now Pronger comes on to man a point in place of Dimitri. Doug Wade on the other one with Boganicki, Burry, and Drake up front. Blues send the puck into the Vancouver zone. Olin gets it near side, sweeps it to the line, past Pronger, and down to the St. Louis zone. Chris Pronger only played 5 minutes in that second period. 11 and a half total in this game. He, too, under the weather. As the Blues are not falling like flies, but a lot of them are hurting. As Burry now moves in on the right side, goes around behind the net, tries to stuff the puck in, but Jovanovski knocked the net off. Red light comes on, no goal. Burry can't believe it. He faked behind the net, came out front, stuffed it in, but Jovanovski had knocked the net off before the puck crossed the line.
Well, I'll say he did, and he's hurt too, Shorty. He's down on all fours, and obviously grimacing in some kind of pain. The Blues are going to really argue on this. What a nice move, though, by Valerie Burry. Did a good job. He faked like he was going to go right around the net. He stopped and then just tucked it in on the short side. But you could clearly see that the goal had been dislodged. Now we're going to have to see the call from up top. Burry getting by his check. And that was Matthias Olin. And then, oh boy, I'll tell you, he really did fake out Dan Klucha. Klucha was way out of the net.
The net was off, though.
But clearly. Oh, clearly off, yeah. But it's a good thing it was. It's a good thing that it was.
So no goal at 1:23 of this third period, and the Blues remain on the power play for another 23 seconds. The faceoff will be to the left of Dan Klucha.
Nice individual effort by Burry, no doubt about that. Kevin Pollock, one of the two referees working this game, explaining to him in no uncertain terms that the goal had been dislodged well before he tucked it in. And Bertuzzi getting a rubdown from Mike Bernstein at the Vancouver bench.
Blues control on the power play. Pronger onto the right wing boards to Stillman. Stillman skates round behind the Vancouver goal. Comes out the far side. Poke check by Salo, but Stillman gets the puck again behind the net. Intercepted by Barron. His clear out blocked by Tkachuk. Here's Burry behind the goal. Back to the left point to Doug Wake. Penalty's now over. Canucks back to full strength. Here's a long shot by Wake, deflected wide. Salo trying to get the puck out. Checked by Burry. Val Burry up the far boards to Stillman. He's checked by Linden. And Trevor will just ice the puck. Bryce Salvador going back to touch it. There'll be a face-off in the Vancouver zone with 2:01 gone here in the third period.
Well, the Blues are 0-for-4. Good penalty killing by Vancouver. Canucks have the one power play goal, which is encouraging. They need to build on that as well. But Bertuzzi's right now, if it stays the way it is, he has scored the winning goal for Vancouver tonight, and what a big one it was. After Nash had tied the game up, a minute and 34 seconds later, bingo, Bertuzzi was able to beat Osgood, and then the Canucks were on their way.
Lucci now covers up and gets jostled by Tyson Nash. That's going to draw a reaction from the Canucks. And we might get penalties out of this as Olin came over. Then looked like he got clipped. Olin talking with official Kevin Pollock now, and we'll see if there's any penalties resulting from this. Doesn't look like it.
Well, lots of traffic in the Vancouver goal, and Nash came through there like he was trying to score a touchdown from 1 yard out. Lowered his head, and then the shoulder pads were right there, and he was going to bull his way right through the crease.
Ed Jovanovski's back on for the Canucks. On defense for the Merrick Malik. Linden to take this draw to the right of Fuchan. He wins it. Jovanovski passes behind the net to Malik. He fires the puck up the middle of the center, just out of the reach of Linden. And Salvador controls with a lead feed to Ryan Johnson. Johnson carries to the Vancouver line, gets the puck to Nash. He puts it in front, slides through to Johnson, and Kluche stopped him. Oh, Ryan Johnson had a good chance right in front, but Kluche made the save and held on.
That's the second very good chance Johnson has had in this hockey game tonight. And Kluche, he has to be feeling a lot better now. He's, for a change, he's got a bit of a cushion, too. Not all the pressure is on his shoulders, and he made a nifty save there with his glove.
Face off to his left. Morrison will take this draw against Corey Stillman. Stillman, Boganicki, and Burry up front. Morrison wins the face off to Matthias Olin. He slides it to the line, held in there, but put out of play by Bryce Salvador. And the fans react as a nice grab is made down there in the corner with 2:28 gone here in the third.
Well, the Canucks have yet to get a shot. Of course, they started the period on the penalty kill, which is understandable. Two by St. Louis. Shots are 25-21. Vancouver up by three goals if you just joined us. Sopel, Bertuzzi, Morrison, and Naslin all scoring for Vancouver tonight.
Here's Olin coming out of his own zone. Lead pass to Morrison, up to Naslin, couldn't handle it. Blues chip the puck back to the Vancouver line. Boganicki has it, he shoots it in deep. Sopel back for the puck, Burry on him. Sopel leads for Olin behind the net. Comes out the far side, stops, now reverses the puck to the near side. Naslin ties up Stillman, so the puck comes out to center. Here's Salvador at his own line. Lead feed out of the reach of Stillman. Puck slides through to Olin in the Vancouver zone. Up to center, here's Morrison. Laflamme had him lined up. Morrison slides the puck ahead. Linden takes it at the St. Louis line and dumps it in deep. Just past the three-minute mark, third period. Canucks up 4-1. Ruchu steals the puck in the blue zone. Tried to center. That was blocked. Now the puck comes back to the line. Jovanovski shoots. That hit Ruchu in front. Chubarov on the rebound. Leads for Linden. His shot stopped by Osgood as he got his stick on that sneaky little shot from Trevor Linden. Canucks work to hold the puck in. Now Jackman gets it behind the St. Louis goal and starts up. Pass to center to Wade. He tips it back. Here comes Dallas Drake. Drake up ahead. Nice feed to Rychinski, but he's checked by Malik. Puck comes through to Kluche. He steers it aside. Jovanovski gets it up to Linden. Out to center. His pass for Cook was out of Matt's reach. Puck slides through to Osgood. He leads for Chris Pronger. Pronger comes up the near side. Out to center. Being shadowed by Cook as he slides the puck in on Kluche. And Danny will cover up for a whistle with 3:53 gone here in the third. And the Canucks still up by three.
Well, the Canucks are in control of this hockey game, and it's the first one really in the series. And St. Louis, a team that has been hit by the flu bug, no doubt about that, trying to muster a little thing, something going here. They dearly would have been able to build if Burry's goal had counted, but the goal was dislodged. So it's a long uphill battle for a St. Louis Blues team that fighting the flu bug and everything else. But the Canucks are certainly making them feel sick right now, too, the way they've played a very spirited Game 5.
Here's Salvador at his own line with a pass ahead. Keith Kachuk leads for Dimitri. He carries it on the right wing. Pavel Dimitri puts the puck in front. Millenby with a one-timer. He slid it wide. Now Kachuk behind the net. Making moves. Dimitri goes to the front. Kachuk comes out the near side. Centers for Millenby out of his reach. And here come the Canucks to center. Brad May chips the puck ahead. Penalty coming up here. And it'll be against St. Louis, slashing against Millenby behind the play. He waves off Kevin Pollock in disgust, but Millenby heads for the box, and the Canucks go to the power play.
The power play is so important in the playoffs. And, you know, I talked about this earlier. Naslund touched on it. The fact that Vancouver's been shut down with the extra attacker is one of the reasons they trail in the series, maybe one of the major ones. But if they can get that cooking right now, you know, it's a funny thing.